We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Incursion, Issue 2 from Valiant Comics. This is a four-part miniseries with a story by Andy Diggle and Alex Paknadel, script by Alex Paknadel, pencils by Doug Braithwaite, colors by Diego Rodriguez, letters by Marshall Dillion. Assistant editor was Drew Baumgartner, associate editor David Menchel, senior editorial direction was Robert Myers. Covers were by Doug Braithwaite with Diego Rodriguez, Ryan Bodenheim with Andrew Dalhouse, and Tansy Zacic. I don't know how to pronounce that. I have cover A. I don't know who did it, but it's an okay cover. It doesn't really tell you about what's going on, and the kid really doesn't appear very much in here, but you get the idea. So Gilad has to take Tama to get help from Doctor Mirage, and she talks like your typical millennial woman, and she has dyed hair, so of course she is a strong, independent woman that hangs out with a ghost man because her husband is a ghost, and she sends Gilad through a dimensional portal into this, like, demonic realm where Imperatrix Virago is apparently living, and she is like a necromancer. The kid Satel is able to convert living things into necromantic energy, which is what the Imperatrix feasts off of. Gilad gets some advice from a demon and has to go across this treacherous area. It's kind of montaged to try and get to the fortress and get inside. Well, things don't quite go as planned, and the Imperatrix is getting impatient. Overall, this was a good issue. I don't like the way Dr. Mirage talked, because it's like every other female character in comics these days has a sort of weird cadence and modernistic talking that normal people don't actually do outside of Twitter. Otherwise, it was good. It was a solid issue. Was it worth $4? No. If it had been an alternate title, it would have easily been worth $2. Easily. But I'm not convinced this was $4 good. The art's solid. Overall, the story is good. I had no problem with that. I thought the writing was good. It just wasn't mind-blowing for $4. And I don't feel like any of the comics that aren't mind-blowing are worth $4. So if this had been a lot cheaper, by about half, I would have really liked it. As it is now, it's not $4 good. I had some problems. I got it home and the cover scuffed up real bad just in the transport. So I think they're using some cheap ink over at Valiant. And the alignment of the book in the cover. The cover slightly off center, so you can see the white outline of the pages. Printer error, obviously, but all the issues on the stand had that, because I went back to see if I could swap it out for another issue, and they had another four copies, and they all looked like that. So I don't know if it was just a bad batch, but I wasn't very happy about it. It's a good issue. It just lacked a lot of the adventure sense to it. It was more somebody narrating you through what was happening. If this had been an issue of Gilad trying to get to the fortress, I would have liked it better, but they kind of montage most of that into a two-page spread, and I think that should have been the entire issue, was him going from point A to point B, and less of him actually at the place, which they did go into. That should have been in issue 3. So this would have been a better issue if it had been a little more drawn out on his journey to show more of the trials and tribulations that he had to go through to get there. And we do learn some secrets about his relation to Tama, how they know each other, that sort of thing. Yeah, I would recommend it. It's still a good issue, just not for cover price. If you can find it for $2, yeah, pick it up. It does a decent enough job recapping you as to what happened that I'm comfortable recommending it, but not for anywhere near cover price. So that's just my take on it. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews, and we hope to see you on the next one.